song, full of the faith that the darkness has taught us. Sing a song, full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on till victory is won. Stony the road we trod, bitter the task we run, felt in the days when hope unborn had died, yet with a steady faith and not a weary feet, come to the place for which our fathers died. We have come over a way that which tears have been watered. We have come treading our path through the blood of the slaughtered. Out of the till now we stand at last, where the bright gleam of a white star is cast.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the official virtual graduation ceremony for the Walter H. Dyett High School for the Arts. As you may know, this is our first graduating class, and we are so very proud of them. I must congratulate and commend our senior class on being strong and enduring one of the most challenging times in our lifetime. This group was denied luncheon, prom, and traditional graduation, and so many of their senior activities. This group's final semester was pretty much ruined by COVID-19, yet they persevered. We, the staff of Dyett, are very, very proud of each of our graduates for their hard work and their diligence. I will certainly miss them coming to my office insisting that they get snacks and also telling me how awful our rules are, you know, but if I had to describe this class with one word, it would be fire. And the reason I chose fire is because they go after what they want and they leave no stone unburned. I am certain that each of them will do very well. I look forward to hearing from each of our graduates as they move on to their next chapter. And so now, let's get ready to jump into our festivities. It gives me a great pleasure to introduce our principal, Mr. Cortez McCoy.
Welcome to the new Dyett's class of 2020 graduation. This is a historical moment as we recognize our very first graduating class. I would like to thank the teachers and staff for making this day possible, as well as Network 17 leaders, Chief Pruitt and Deputy Smith. I would also like to thank the parents and families for supporting their students and making this day possible. Also, we cannot forget the community groups and hunger strikers that protested to ensure Dyett's reopening. Though this is not a traditional graduation, I'm excited to celebrate our seniors. Our seniors have been accepted to Illinois State, U of I, Champaign-Urbana, Howard, Columbia, Grambling, and a host of other prestigious institutions. They also have allocated over $3 million in scholarships. I have never been more proud to be a Dyett Eagle. To begin our ceremony, we will hear from the former and founding principal, Ms. Beulah McLeod.
Class of 2020, congratulations to all the parents, students, and family members who are with us today. I want to take this time out to say congratulations to you on your accomplishment of being the first graduating class of the new Walter H. Dyett High School for the Arts. And I have to admit that when I thought about what I wanted to say to you today, I was really overwhelmed with a variety of thoughts and feelings and emotions. First, because there's so much going on right now, and so I know whatever I say to you needs to be timely. But second of all, because you all were my babies, the first group to come through the new school. So after a lot of time and thought, I actually came up with a few things to say to you today, which I really hope you take to heart. And the first thing I want to say to you today is simply, you matter. I know there are a lot of messages that you're being bombarded with at this time that might say the contrary, but the truth is that you matter, and I know that. I have tangible evidence of that. 5 years ago, when I was traveling around Brownsville to recruit you guys from eighth grade and going to your elementary school and taking the time to sit with you and talk to you and sit with your parents on 46 in Dearborn and interview students, and I took the time to actually make sure you all had a good understanding of what Walter H. Dyett High School for the Arts could be, a few things stuck out to me. Number one, you were willing to take a chance when no one else would. We did not have a building. We did not have a school. All we had was a hope and a dream about what was possible. So you matter because your particular class was the first class to believe that you could redefine what it meant to be a Black student in the city of Chicago on the South Side in a neighborhood high school. You were the first group who took a chance to change the narrative on what was possible for a group of students who lived in this area in the Brownsville community to make a difference. You matter. And I know you matter because you shattered every single stereotype about what was possible for neighborhood schools in the city of Chicago, whether it be the freshman on track rate of 96%, whether it be the first tech incubation space in a school with a major corporation in the city of Chicago in the Brownsville community, whether it be the trips to Japan that you took out of the country, whether it be all of the scholarship dollars that you received to date. You shattered every stereotype about what it means to be a Black student in the city of Chicago during this time. You matter. The second thing that I will say to you is that you are the change that we need. You are the change agents that will take your communities and society to the next level. And I know this. I have evidence of it. During the Laquan McDonald situation, I saw you peacefully protest in respectable manners. I saw you raise and elevate your voice in meaningful ways. I saw you reach out to the local community through service learning projects, through schools across the city, particularly in the Brownsville area, to demonstrate the fact that you wanted to make a difference where you were. You are the change that we seek. And third of all, I'll end with this. We love you. Simply put, we love you. You matter. You are the change that we seek. And we love you. I'm asking you today to take the same spirit of risk-taking, to take the same spirit of perseverance, to take the same spirit of shattering stereotypes into the next phase of your life and continue to be the change agents that you were by putting the new Walter H. Dyett High School for the Arts on the map in the most positive way. You did it. You did it. You took a chance. And I just want to let you know, and your parents know, I love you all for it. Congratulations, class of 2020. I've seen you guys grow up over the past 4 years, I'm so proud of your growth and evolution. I look forward to seeing the change that you will make, and know that I will always be here for you, and I love you guys. Bye-bye.
I am Alderwoman Jeanette Taylor, and I want to say to the Walter H. Dyett class of 2020, we are so proud of you. You made it. This is only the beginning of your next journey. Just know in your hearts and mind that the Dyett Hunger Strikers got your back. Congratulations.
Hi, my name is Irene Robinson. I am one of the former Dyett Hunger Strikers, and I'm also the education organizer for the Kenwood Open Community Organization. Congratulations, Dyett Class of 2020. This is an extraordinary moment in our life, as it is in your life, as it is in ours. As I proudly watch you all begin a new journey, many adventures you will travel through. Life to fulfill your dreams. Let no one take them from you. Fight to overcome any obstacles that you may face to accomplish your goal. You are more than accomplished. You are kings and queens. Believe in yourself as we believe and love you. The impossible is possible. Many people told us that it was impossible to save Walter H. Dyett. Many people told us that it was impossible to reopen a closed school. Once again, the impossible was possible. Young people kicked off the fight to save Dyett. Despite the obstacle that they was going through, they continue to fight, and parents united with them together. And once again, history was made. Our history is a legacy of love. We want to continue to carry on while we continue to make more history. The struggle is real, but we don't run away from it. We stand up and we fight back together. I know this, and I know that you will accomplish your goal and fulfill your dreams, and let no one dictate who you are or determine what you're gonna be. The impossible is possible, I know. I'm looking at it. The Dyett Senior Class of 2020. As we stand here, my dream, our dream, for you is a reality now. Yes, the impossible happened. Walter H. Dyett reopened the doors to the future of generations of leaders. And once again, history was made. Walter H. Dyett graduate class of 2020, this is a historical moment for us all. Know your history. Go out in the world and continue to shape it. Shape it into something beautiful and rightfulness for every child, woman, and man. Continue the legacy of love that was given to you. Dyett Class 2020, congratulations. Dyett 2020, congratulations. You are truly amazing. We did it. Thank you.
Greetings to the Dyett High School Class of 2020. I'm Reverend Robert Jones, pastor of Mount Carmel Missionary Baptist Church here in the near South Side, as well as one of the Dyett Hunger Strikers. We're so proud of the accomplishments that you have made. Remember the message of the Sankofa bird, I walk with my back to the future. As you go forward, remember those behind you who have suffered, who have struggled, who have toiled, who have worked to make your day on this day possible. Now it's your turn. We ask you to continue to strive. We're so proud of you. You are the fruit of the success of those who would not say no, who would not lay down, who would not stop, who experienced pain and suffering so that you could be successful. Continue to be successful. Again, we're so proud of you. May God bless you and take care.
Dyett 2020 graduates, congratulations. As you take this step, don't forget how in 2015, 12 community members found the strength, took the risk to go on a hunger strike, to win the right to save this school. You were birthed from that strength that made us risk our lives for social change. We said enough is enough. Yes, times have been tough, but we know you got the stuff.
That's right.
And in this historic year of 2020, as African Americans say, enough is enough. And people all over the world join hands, start a love train, and protest for a new day, a new way. You have faced tough times and made it through. On this historical day, we celebrate you, your time, your song, your struggle, your strong. In the face of COVID and hate, remember, even in your youth, you have a part to play. Stand for the truth. Keep growing and learning to make a new day. We know whatever comes, you got what it takes to keep on keeping on, to make it through. Dyett class of 2020, we celebrate you. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Dyett class of 2020. My name is Anna Jones. I'm one of the parents who stopped eating for plus 30 days to make sure that you guys have a great educational opportunity. I kind of wrote a speech for you guys today, but I wasn't sure if it was too long or not, and I really wanted to speak from the heart and not look down at my paperwork. So I'm kind of put this together and hope that you guys can understand the message today. I wanted to talk about what is discrimination. Discrimination is treating people unfairly or considering groups of people unfairly, like people because of their skin color. Those things happen to our kids in Chicago public schools. When I was struck with discrimination, it hit me like lightning. I didn't want another child to feel what I was experiencing. I didn't want another mother to feel what I was experiencing. And I didn't want you kids to miss out on a great educational opportunity. Although I'm upset and it's unfortunate what we had to do to make sure that you guys have an education at Dyett High School, I'm elated to know that it was for a good reason. I'm glad to know that you children had the opportunity of a great start, and I hope that you don't stop at this point. I hope this makes you want to fight harder. I hope that you understand with perseverance, a good attitude, and a good education, like what we was fighting for Dyett, what we continue to fight for all over the world for kids everywhere, is that you take this opportunity and keep this positive attitude and continue to seek a great education, continue to fight for things that so that makes sure that students do not ever have to experience violence, intimidation, harassment, and threats from just getting a good education. You mean so much to us. Know that. Please know that. We did everything we could before we starved to see you have a good education. We do anything to see you win, even if it means stop eating for 34 days. I will never forget being too weak to push my son on a swing in a park. But I will never forget the reason why I was so weak. I am so happy and so proud of you guys today. And I hope you never stop fighting for what's for you. And that's a great educational opportunity. That's a lifetime of experience. And I hope you never give up. Love, blessings, peace, and happiness forever. Congratulations. Congratulations, Dyett graduates of 2020.
Dyett High School for the Arts Class of 2020. How you guys doing? It's Jared Payton here. First and foremost, I want to say thank you to Principal McCoy, and I hope this message finds you well. And thank you for giving me an opportunity to be able to share a message with all of these young people. Listen, in life, man, we go through tough times. And especially right now, as we're going through tough times, we're always trying to figure out what's the message or what we can take from it. And I think in every single situation that we go through, we gotta find a way to be able to take something from a good situation or a bad situation and how it can make us grow. One thing that I know through what you guys are going through right now with this pandemic is that you are going to get stronger through all of this. This is going to be a part of your history. This is going to be a part of your greatness and figuring out how you grew from these tough times. Listen, I go back to the time when I inducted my dad in the Hall of Fame. I was a young teenager, had no clue what I was doing. But for me, now I look back on it, I was the first son to ever induct his dad into the Pro Football Hall of Fame. Nobody else can say that they were the first. And this is the first graduating class. You guys are creating history. You're making history. And that's the fact that people are going to not only remember that, you set the bar, and now everybody else has to figure out how to be able to get to that point. And when you set the bar, it's a feeling that you have for a lifelong lessons of all these things that we all go through, but that people will be looking at you, each and every one of you, as the first. So I hope you guys hold that dear to your heart. I hope you guys take everything that you're going through right now and taking it and turning it into a positive. And finding a way through these tough times to get closer to the ones you love, to find out more things in your life that you're passionate about, things that you want to create, things that you want to start. Take those things, put them underneath you, and let them be the foundation and the stepping stone to your greatness. Each one of you has greatness inside of you. You do. You have greatness inside of you. It's figuring out what you want to do in life and how you want to be remembered to create your own legacy. Each one of you will. Every day that you wake up, you're writing a new story in your book. I tell my kids all the time, make sure it's a story that you want people to read. Not every single chapter is going to be great. It's not. Not every chapter is going to be great. But it's your story. You create it. You mold it. And every single day that you wake up, make sure you're taking advantage of every single opportunity that you have to find out what you're passionate about and your greatness. I hope you guys are doing well. Hope this message finds you well. And I look forward to meeting some of you guys down the line as you guys create your greatness and you create your legacy. Hope you guys are all well. As always, I was here, but now I'm gone. Peace.
And now we will hear from our class valedictorian, Miss Maya Wood. Good evening, fellow graduates, families, friends, and staff. My name is Maya Wood, and it's an honor to be the valedictorian for the class of 2020. It seems as if the first day of freshman year was yesterday. I remember eagerly walking inside the building, expecting high school to be some type of alternate universe. If anything, I thought it would be just like the movies. Thousands of upperclassmen towering above us, students freely roaming the halls, off-campus lunch, dancing on tables, and random a cappella moments. Except it was far from High School Musical. It was something that years of Disney Channel couldn't prepare me for. It was the complete opposite. Dyett started off with 150 freshmen. We were a part of the foundation for this school. We filled up those empty seats. We set the tone. We set the culture. We are the first class. We wouldn't be sitting here today if it weren't for unity. We wouldn't be here if it weren't for our community leaders who went on a 34-day hunger strike to keep this school open. And it wouldn't have been possible without the courage of those first who gave us a chance to be students. Thank you thank you to our former principal, Ms. McCloy, and our counselor, Mr. Bolar, who pushed us to stay on our A game and strive for the best. Thank you, Mr. McCoy, Ms. Butler, and Mr. Culler and staff for extending opportunities to many and filling in important leadership roles. It's notably right to also thank the teachers who greeted us with open arms and pushed us to be great students from day one. Thank you, Mr. Fierguy, Ms. Florzak, Mr. Clemens, Mr. Ross, and Ms. Allende, and also to those who joined along the way. Mr. McKay, Ms. Antonio, Ms. Cray, Mr. Duran, Mr. Horwat, and everyone else who kept a smile on our faces. We love and appreciate you. Thank you to my mom, dad, family, friends, and DePaul Posse for always encouraging me to grow and be a better person. Although the year has taken an unexpected turn, and it seems as if the world is falling apart, I'm grateful that tonight we can come together to celebrate our accomplishments. I wish you all the best of luck in your futures. Thank you.
From the 2020 class salutatorian, Mikhail Eggleston.
Class of 2020, we're here. Today is a monumental and joyous occasion through an unprecedented time. But it has been a time of sacrifice, patience, pain, love, oppression, and most importantly, unity. And we are still here. We have taken losses. What we must not lose is not just who we are, but what we are meant to be and who we are meant to be. So don't let anyone or anything bring you down or extinguish your fire, your drive. From a hairdresser to an architect, be that and do it in flying colors. And appreciate what's in front of you, because you have a lot to be grateful and to be smiling for. I am honored to be salutatorian. How I got here consists of a mentality we all possess, the champion mentality. Whether it's for a grade, racial injustice, legal reform, trials in life, be relentless and be the champion of your life. Invest in yourself, push yourself, love and be yourself. Rise to the occasion, believe in your dreams, and never give up on something worth fighting for. To our teachers, faculty, and parents who put their best foot forward, you are revered, honored, respected, and loved. We wouldn't be here without you. We are a reflection of you, and we will continue to show that your hard work was worth it. Today is about a journey, one that includes us all. Although our paths may differ, we still have one goal in mind, success and happiness. We've made mistakes, but we're blooming into ambitious and bright people who just want to make their mark on the world. And there's a joy in thinking about what we can accomplish as our horizon only begins to reveal itself. And with this journey so far, it feels good. So let's enjoy this moment. Tell someone you appreciate them. Pat yourself on the back and keep living, loving, and learning. And as we move through the next phases and stages of our life, remember that one day we will reach the mountaintop. Love you all and fly high, Dyett Eagles. Yay!
Hello to all of our Dyett Eagles family, Principal McCoy, parents, teachers, staff, friends, and graduates. To the class of 2020, you did it. As a 2002 graduate of Dyett Middle School, and a 2006 graduate of Dyett Academic Center High School, it is an honor to speak to the Walter H. Dyett High School for the Arts first graduating class. And today, I am proud to be a Dyett Eagle. You have made it through four arduous years of living and learning. Today marks an incredible moment in your lives. You have overcome the incessant daily pressures of social media, personal obstacles with family and living circumstances, however difficult, and grappling with the idea that as Black men and women, you're often counted out. And while you certainly would have liked the euphoric feeling of playing your final varsity game, getting turned at your senior prom, and walking across the stage of graduation to your parents' and family's cheers, graduating high school is still a tremendous achievement and is not to be cheapened by the absence of these things due to COVID-19. There will be more moments to celebrate when you can do so safely. Today marks the end of a journey and the start of a new journey. Only this time, the stakes are higher. There will be new wins, new losses, new joys, and new pains. Here are a few lessons that I have learned from my personal experiences that I think will serve you well. And I hope they can help you on your journey as they have come to help me on mine. First, never forget where you come from. I was born in Inglewood. My mother and father were not in my life, and I nearly became property of a broken foster care system, but for my grandmother adopting my six other siblings and I. Yes, there were seven of us. We were poor, shopped at thrift stores for new clothes before it became cool, and reused paper plates and cups for our everyday dinnerware. Despite nights where I wish I had someone else's life, now I couldn't have asked for a better experience. I didn't realize that the very struggle that I resisted so much prepared me so much for the world and for my future. This is important. All that you are and all that you will become is the sum total of your experiences. This provides you with a unique advantage over other more privileged folks who had easier access to the very things you had to work hard for. Leadership, hard work, grit, tenacity, sacrifice, problem solving. These are traits and soft skills that provide you an edge in the many settings you will encounter. These are skills that I have gained through those difficult moments in Inglewood. Your identity matters. Your story matters. Where you come from matters. Never forget that, and it will serve you well. Next, I say, stay in the deep end. Michael Jordan once said, I have failed over and over, and that is why I succeed. For every person you know that is hashtag goals, checking a bag in a great career, or making money on their terms as an entrepreneur, they all have one thing in common, failure. After finishing college in 2010, I knew I wanted to become a lawyer. I didn't know any lawyers, and I was the most educated person in my family. In 2012, I moved to Charlotte to attend a for-profit law school that had just been recently accredited. This was one of the few options after having been denied to the nation's best law schools and waitlisted at others. I finished undergrad with a 2.7 GPA and subpar LSAT scores, so I took what I could get. It was a faith move. Well, after my first semester, I was on academic probation, and the next semester I was academically dismissed. I received news of my dismissal while I was in Shanghai, China on an international legal internship. So it was my first time out of the United States. I had no money and was no longer a law student. I failed. I thought I let my family down and I let myself down. I eventually made my way back to Chicago and told myself I will be back in law school in 2 years. Well, in 2015, I kept that promise and was admitted to the John Marshall Law School here in Chicago as a part-time evening student. But this time, the stakes were higher. I was also working a full-time job for the Chicago City Council. There were difficult moments, setbacks, and times I wanted to stop, but I didn't. And in 2019, I earned my Juris Doctorate. Today, as a Black man and as a lawyer, I am glad I did not quit. So to you, I say, stay in the deep end. Playing small and shallow waters will not serve you, will not test you, and will not force you to grow. There will be moments where you venture out into the uncharted deep waters with crashing waves to knock you over and rising tides sweeping your feet from beneath you. Take the risk, fail big, do not quit. Keep kicking, keep swimming. It will be uncomfortable. It will be challenging, but you will eventually reach your destination. Do not run from life's difficult moments. Stay in the deep end. To close, I want to remind you that you are well equipped to take charge of your future. Great men and women are born for the times that they are needed the most. And right now, in this city, in this country, and in this world, we are witnessing a shift. You are our next leaders, our doctors, our lawyers, our teachers. You are the generation of unashamed, unafraid change makers. It is your charge to impact every environment you occupy. And on this new journey, you will. God bless you, and congratulations to the Walter H. Dyett High School for the Arts Class of 2020.
Hello, everybody. My name is Terrell Sass. I'm a Grammy-nominated producer, musician, multi-instrumentalist, and entrepreneur. I've been blessed to work with artists like T.I., Ludacris, Rick Ross, Nelly, Bun B, Pharrell, Tyler Perry, Chicago's own Donnell Jones, and many, many, many more. I would like to thank Ms. Butler for giving me the opportunity to congratulate the 2020 graduating class at Dyett High School for the performing arts. Congratulations, your hard work paid off. I really just want to encourage you, give you some lifelong lessons that I learned that I wish I knew when I just went into the world of performing arts as a professional. The first thing I want to say is, as best as you can, the most important thing is stay out of trouble, because no matter how talented you are, if you're not in a place where you can show the world your talent, it's useless. So there's not much more I can say about that, but as the best you can, stay around positive people that encourage you to stay out of trouble. And that way your art can be shown and seen. The next thing I want to let you know is talent alone isn't going to always get you where you deserve to be. So sometimes marketing is as important or more important than your talent. You could be in the basement all day dancing or perfecting your craft, whatever it is, but if no one sees it and no one knows you do it, what are you going to get out of it? So focus on the marketing as much as you focus on the talent, you know, be it through social media. Make sure everybody knows what you do. And the next point is tied to that one. Your social media is the new business card. So make sure it represents the brand that you want potential employers of you to see. You know, make sure you portray yourself the way you want them to see you. Because I have friends that didn't get gigs, not because of their talent, but because of that post they did that showed them showed themselves speeding 100 miles per hour. So the artist was like, I can't hire him because he does risky stuff like that. So that matters. The next point, which ties to that one, is you're always performing. You're not just performing when you're on stage. You're performing when you get on the tour bus, get off the tour bus. When you get on the plane, get off the plane. People are always watching you, and you don't want anyone to not hire you because of how they see you act or how they're afraid you might treat people. So always act how you want a stranger to see you act. You know, and my rule is if I wouldn't do it in front of my mom, I don't need to be doing it anyway, because somebody's mom is watching me, even if whether I know it or not. Next point, network. Back to what I was talking about earlier. Make sure everyone knows what you do, how you do it, and how good you do it. I could bring any conversation back to what I do. I could be in a store and I'll say, hey, I have that same carpet in my studio. I mean, I really don't care about that, but that's my way of telling that person I have a studio. And then that turns into, oh, what kind of studio? What do you do? Oh, I know so-and-so. My cousin manages so-and-so. So-and-so babysits so-and-so's kids. Like, it sounds funny, but that's how a lot of interesting connections happen. And the last thing I want to say, don't be afraid to think out the box and think about ownership. Don't always try to be the guy working for the company. Be the person that owns the company, the guy or the girl, sorry. Like this shirt I'm wearing, it's a picture of me. I turned it into a logo, you know? So I sell merchandise, masks with the pandemic going on, shirts, and it's a part of my brand. Like it's on everything. So think outside the box. Use your gifts to get you in other places. But then how you market and brand that, it all helps you in the long run. So think outside the box, think ownership. Own the dance studio. Don't just be a great dancer. Because the older you get, you're gonna learn the power is in ownership. There are people who have half of our talent that are places we should be just because they own things. So that's a few of the golden nuggets I have for you. Congratulations. Keep up the good work. Once again, I want to thank Ms. Butler for having me. Anytime you need me, I'm there. You follow me on Instagram at Terrell Sass, T-E-R-R-E-L-L-S-A-S-S, and DM me, let me know you saw this speech, and I'll keep in touch with you. I'll be glad in any connections or info that I can give to any of you, I'll do it. God bless you. Congratulations. Wish you the best.
Yo, what's up? It's your boy, the Destin Legend, Leon Rogers, 107.5 WGCI, Chicago's number one for hip hop and R&B, a comedian and just a son of Chicago. And I'm proud and honored to be here today to recognize the graduating class of 2020 of Dyett High School. Listen, you guys have went through a lot this year. You went through a lot, man, but you did it. You know what I'm saying? You did it. You completed it. That's all that matters, man. Between coronavirus, all the stuff that's going on with the protests, man, and the riots, you made it. You did it. That means you're special, very special. Especially all that's been going on this year, for you to be able to fight through that and graduate, that means a lot. You guys are special. You are meant for greatness. Don't ever forget that. Now, before I leave, I want to put something on your brain. This is a code I live by. It's called the 5 P's, okay? I came up with this a while back, and I wonder, how can I make myself better? How can I push myself to be the best? Well, I live my life by the 5 P's. The first P is passion. You gotta have a passion for something. So I want every one of you to sit and think about something that you'd like to do. Even if you had to do it for free, you'd do it all day. Whether that be writing songs, making clothes, being a DJ, making people laugh, whatever. Find a passion. Find a passion that's gonna fuel you. Find a passion. The second P is pride. Then you gotta take pride in that passion. I'm a stand-up comedian. I love to make people laugh. I would do that for free all day, every day. I'd make a room laugh if you gave me the opportunity. But I also take pride in my passion by writing new jokes, trying to come up with new material, reading the newspaper, trying to stay up on current events so I can be the best comic that I can possibly be. Taking acting classes, whatever it is to make me better as a comedian, that's what I do. Take pride in your passion. Now here goes the third P. This is the one that's a tough one. It's perseverance. You're gonna be told no a lot more times than you're told yes. And I want everybody to look down at the color of their skin, first and foremost. You're gonna get told no a lot, but you gotta be ready for that yes. That's where perseverance comes in. So if you got passion, you got pride, and you got perseverance, then the fourth one, that's what everybody loves. Number four is profit. You're gonna get money, you're gonna gain happiness, you're gonna gain success. That's a profit too, okay? You're gonna gain profit because you have a passion, you took pride in that passion, you persevered through all the BS like y'all did this year to graduate, and now look at the profit, you're graduating. Look at the profit if you have a job and you take passion and pride in that job and you persevere. You move up through the company. You gain money, you gain knowledge, you gain wealth. That's all profit. So don't just look at profit as money. Look at profit as gaining positive life experience and moving forward. And the last P, which is the most important one, and I'm really gonna be on y'all about this one, it's called philanthropy. That's right. You need, when you go off to college and you have your college experience, you need to come back. Come back to Dyett, come back to other schools in your neighborhood, grammar schools, elementary schools, and let the students know that there's much more of a road to travel, much more of a successful road to travel, and they can look at you as the blueprint. As I try to go back and talk to high school students, talk to grammar school students, St. Margaret of Scotland is the grammar school I graduated from. I still go back to it to this day if they call me. Just like I'm here at Dyett talking to you all today, you need to go back to your schools when you go to college. Come back, whether you go to college, whether you go get a job, whether you join the military, come back and talk about your great experiences. Talk about the bad ones too, to let them know that it's not always gonna be sweet, but always put at the end of the day, make sure you're positive and that let them know that if I came from here, you can come from here too. It's just that easy, it's just that simple. Look, I love you guys. This is gonna pass. Remember, community, positivity, and solidarity. We can't get anywhere yelling at each other.
What can I say about our next guest? He's an activist, he's an educator, he's a strong black man with high principles. He has dedicated his life to ensuring that African-American young people have equal opportunities, especially in education. He is the executive director of the Kenwood Oakwood Community Organization, most known as Coco. When Dyett was closed in 2015, G2 and an aggregation of activists staged a hunger strike. These activists garnered national attention, and this led to the reopening of Dyett, the new Dyett. So today we present the Eagle Award to Mr. G2 Brown for his heroism, his strength of character, and his fortitude.
Good evening and congratulations, Dyett graduates. I'm G2 Brown of the Kenwood Oakland Community Organization and Journey for Justice Alliance, and was the organizer behind the hunger strike that created Dyett High School. We are so proud of you. You are the dreams that we've been waiting for. We knew that this day would come, and we want to say to you that in the times that we're living right now, with people demanding justice, with people having a burning desire for a better world, that same feeling that 12 mothers and fathers had when they knew that you were coming is what you should have in your heart moving forward. Don't accept the status quo. Know that you are not just responsible for yourself, but to lift another brother and sister up, to lift a young person up, to make sure that you realize that we are each other's keeper. So thank you very much. I'm proud of you. You stay strong. Keep moving.
Hello, everyone. Today is a milestone for us all. The seniors have made it through a rough but wonderful 4 years. We can now graduate and say we did it. But we wouldn't be able to be here without you. Every single one of you put your lives at risk for the students that are here now at Dyett High School. You didn't eat any solid foods for weeks and protested until the school was opened back up. I know it was a lot of hard days, but it was all worth it at the end. Because you now have blessed hundreds of students and adults. Thank you for saving the school and making it better. Thank you for G2. Thank you, G2, for coming up to the school and providing us with opportunities and teaching us something new. Thank you for sacrificing so much for us. You are all blessings and deserve the world. Dyett High School will always cherish you and make sure every single student and parent knows what you have done for us. Without you guys, there will be no Dyett High School. Thank you.
Next, we will have the presentation of our graduates by our assistant principal, Ms. Dory Butler, and our school counselor, Ms. Naisha Pruitt. Your age, I didn't worry like I think you do.
in the Lord's Prayer before they go to bed at night, like my daddy did for me and his mother before him. Well, something about it just keeps you right, and I hope you don't work too much overtime so you can be right there beside them when they close their little eyes. 'Cause they'll outgrow the shoes, they'll outgrow
make a second.
them the Lord's Prayer before they go to bed at night. Like my daddy did for me and his mother before him. Well, something about it just keeps you right. And I hope you don't work too much overtime, so you can be right there beside me when they close their eyes. 'Cause they'll outgrow their shoes, they'll outgrow their beds, they'll outgrow. Back then in like my daddy did for me and his mother before him. Well, something about it just keeps you right. And I hope you don't work too much overtime so you can be right there beside them. They'll outgrow the shoes, they'll outgrow the beds, they'll outgrow that house, and you can't stop it. Life will line your face, time will turn the page, but they're still gonna be your babies, just like your stairs. Full of questions that I them the Lord's Prayer before they go to bed at night. Like my daddy did for me and his mother before him. Well, something about it just keeps you right. And I hope you don't work too much overtime so you can be right there beside me. They'll outgrow the shoes, they'll outgrow the beds, they'll outgrow that house, and you can't stop it. Life will line your face, time will turn the page, but they're still gonna be your babies, just like your stairs.
Just don't forget when you're all grown up.
say, I hope you teach them the Lord's Prayer before they go to bed at night, like my daddy did for me and his mother before him. Well, something about it just keeps you right. And I hope you don't work too much overtime, so you can be right there beside them. And they close their little eyes, 'cause they'll outgrow the shoes, they'll outgrow the beds.
To the Dyett High School class of 2020. This is Danny Green here. I just want to congratulate you guys on graduating, from making history, being the first graduating class since the reopening of the school, since the community went on a hunger strike to get the school reopened. It's amazing. You guys had a rough year. I know it's been tough, but continue to stay positive. Continue to encourage each other. Stay close. Appreciate your loved ones. Stay safe and much success ahead. So congratulations, and continue to you know, push through and stay encouraged. Things will get back to normal soon, and we'll be back playing soon and hopefully entertaining you guys soon. Congratulations to the class of the new Dyett High School.
Dyett High School, it's Christina Milian. Congratulations, you guys. You made it. It's your graduation. This is amazing. I wish you all the best, all you talented people out there. Make the best of your life. You've gotten this far. The sky's the limit.
Greetings, teachers and staff, parents and families, and of course, the class of 2020. Despite everything that is happening in the world, graduation is a joyous occasion that you will forever remember, and you deserve to be celebrated. You all have beat the odds and have become the new Dyett's first graduating class. From community protests and hunger strikes to get the school open, and now surviving through a pandemic and issues of race, justice, equality, and equity. Your class will be remembered and characterized for its perseverance and resilience. You all are unstoppable. I would be remiss not to leave you with some gems. Number one, be yourself. The world is your oyster. Make it cool to be smart and educated. Make it cool to work hard and show effort. Others will follow suit. The universe is yielding to you the more you give of your true self. Number two, face your fears. Face the challenges. Through rejection and challenges is how you grow. Martin Luther King said it best. The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands in times of challenge and controversy. How will you stand? It is fight or flight. Will you fly away from the challenge or take on the challenge? The choice is yours. Number three, start with small positive habits. Small habits are simplistic foundations that lead to complex structures and success. Things like opening up your laptop every day, even when school or work is over, will lead to successful business ideas, the completion of that book you've been writing, as well as other business ventures. Not missing any days of class prepares you for the discipline you will need to be successful. Listen to one positive message every morning to start your day. These small positive habits will lead to that big change. Number four, share your experience and give back. In the words of the prolific poet and artist, Aubrey Graham, better known as Drake, he said, I told my story and made his story. People will learn from you, and from this, history will be made. Your guidance and mentorship will give someone the blueprint to achievement and create an enterprise of affluent people. Speaking of affluent people, surround yourself with others that will encourage, motivate, and inspire you. Those will be the ones that will lift you up when you are going through perilous times. Carry this with you as you navigate this beautiful thing called life. Class of 2020, I couldn't be more proud, and you should be proud as well. Give yourselves a hand. At this time, graduates, please move your tassel from right to left, symbolizing you have graduated. I wish you much success as you go on to college and adulthood.
Hey, what's up, y'all? Sid the Entertainer. Shout out to the class of 2020. Man, big up to y'all, man. You know, this is what it's all about. This is the first graduating class since the school reopened, and y'all know what it took. People in that community went on a hunger strike so y'all can go to school. They did not eat. It wasn't no bologna sandwiches. There wasn't nobody cooking no grilled cheese. Everybody said, look, we want the school open so these kids can go out here and make some history. And y'all gonna do it. Damn it, y'all gonna do it. I'm sorry. I'm not gonna cuss at the kids. I'll take that back. But y'all gonna do it, guys. Stay focused, all right? Be encouraged. Go out there. Be amazing. You guys are getting out of high school, going into the world. We need your voices. We need your courage. We need your attitudes to make this world a better place, all right? Congratulations to all of you, right? Thank you so much, man. Principal McCoy and AP Butler, big up to y'all, man. Congratulations to everybody. I'll holla.
Said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hate and say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. That was never friendly, yeah. Now I'm jumping out of Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I mean, it's like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 bags, yeah. But they didn't know me last year, yeah. Everyone wanna act like they important, but all that mean nothing when I saw my door, yeah. Everyone counting on me, drop the ball, yeah. Everything custom like I'm at the bottom, yeah, yeah. If you win it, put your lattice to the sky. How could it all make sense when I got millions on my mind? Coming with it, I just put it to the side. Bought a sense of baby, they could see it in my eyes. My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I wouldn't be nothing. Now they say congratulations. Work so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hate and say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
I was patient, yeah. Oh, I was patient. Hey, oh. Now I can scream that we made it. Now everywhere I go, they say congratulations. Young graduation. Yeah. I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I got a situation. Number old Ben Frank. Big ring, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in a trap, though. Pot so big, call it Super Bowl. Super Bowl, caught up, get in the rose. Top flow lifestyle, top hunch on my post. Yeah. Malone, I got a play on my phone. You know what I'm on. Hunch your Houdini is gone.
My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hate and say we changing, look, we made.